And pray that you send forth your Holy Spirit in each one of us, so that we may continue to do what you will us to do. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so good evening once again, everyone. So we weren't able to meet for two meetings. No, the first one is I have a poor internet connection, and the second meeting, natimingan nga Chinese New Year. So since ang iban nga sections naka-start naman mi og klase sa history of Sagay, so we are going to discuss that one for tonight, okay? Ang history of Sagay, which is lesson 2. So probably it will take siguro an hour and a half or 2 hours of discussion. Just make yourself comfortable, and I do hope that mamati ka muno, kaya syempre I will be asking also questions along the way. Now, supposedly this week would be intended for an asynchronous activity, because that is what the other sections are doing. But since we miss out on 2 meetings, we have to double time, no? Kaya we weren't able ganit to meet last time with regards to the continuation of the history of Nanesco, so I only gave you a pre-recording video as your reference. So syempre kasayang man nga ma left out mo sa progress sa ibang nga section. So although nag-activity ang ibang nga sections, hindi man kamo ma left out ana, because I will also be giving you the same activity right after our class. But the only advantage lang is that I will be extending the deadline until next week. Unlike sa ibang nga sections nga until siya tonight only lang. Syempre, I will have to give you the benefit of the doubt since we miss a few meetings. So, make up classes ta. And then, the activity will just be given to you tonight. But, I will extend the deadline for the sake na you can pass no on time. Okay? Hindi mo mag-overgid ka cramming. So, me first open my presentation. Wait lang. Ah, by the way, while we wait, di ano, your prelims examination will be next week, Friday. It will be done online, the usual, just like last semester. So you are given 2 hours to finish the exam, and then please, no, just make sure that you review. Although, araraman na sa mga slides ang kwaon ang mga questions, but there will be a time nga your presentations will not be available, no, to you. So also, there are some questions po nga dili man jud siya ingon nga kinanglan i-research, no, so you have to really answer it based on your own understanding. Now the exam will run for 2 hours, okay, and then right after ana din na to na siya extend. So make sure you have a strong internet connection for next week, okay? It will start from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. ang ato ang prelims exam. Also, kindly remember nga sa ato ang prelims examination, it will be accessed through Google Classroom, and then you'll answer it via Google Form, just like last semester. With regards to your scores, please be patient with me. Nadungan man ang ato ang prelims sa SUN, no? State University of Northern Negros, and ang prelims exam po sa Santa Rita. So, I will be checking a lot of test papers. Please be patient. I will return the scores man japon to you in due time, okay? Also, the coverage for the exam will be from the very beginning. So, atong lesson 1, the importance of studying history, and then history of State University of Northern Negros, and then, actually, aram na sa mga slides, and then tonight's topic, which will be the history of Sagay, okay? Let me first share my screen. And I will show you a video pod later on, and I will be asking questions. So, please, if you are important buhaton, please pay attention sa to ang lesson for tonight. Although I am not a pure-blooded sa gaynon, no? I do hope that I'll be able to do justice, no, in discussing with you the history and profile of Sagay City and Negros Occidental. So lesson 2 is actually divided into two parts, knowing medyo extensive, no, ang coverage ni lesson 2. That's why for now, for our prelims coverage, I will only be discussing Sagay City. Then for midterms, ang Negros Occidental na lang na history. So today's topic will present the history and profile of Sagay City, later na lang noon ang Negros Occidental, and we'll be unboxing. Oh, di unboxing, unboxing video nga kana. But we'll be unboxing the wonders of Sagay City, no. We will be going back in time, no, and try to understand, because the topics will be is arranged chronologically. We will start from the very beginning, from the Spanish era, no, down to the conversion of Sagay as a city. So for us to fully appreciate, no, the progress, no, and the development of city throughout the course of time. So the learning outcome for tonight is you will be able to trace the history of Sagay City and the province of Negros Occidental. So Sagay City can be identified in the map of Negros Occidental because of its ice cream cone shape. If you look at the map here, no, in the right side of the presentation, you will see that in the northern part of Negros Occidental, this is Negros, ha, kaning cream-colored gagi divide into several municipalities and cities. Well, sa lower half niya, in red or in light salmon color, that is Oriental na, no? So, since Oriental and Occidental both share Negros Island. So, the cone shape, or masyag pizza slice, no, is Sagay City. Okay? Used to be municipality of Sagay, then previously called Magallanes, then yun previously called Argueles. Sakto ba? Argueles. So, it's a ice cream cone slice shape, no? From the northern tip of Negros. It is bounded in the north by the Asuncion Pass and the Visayas Sea. And the city of Talisay and municipality of Calatrava in the south. Cities of Cadiz and Silay in the west. And city of Escalante and municipality of Toboso in the east. The name of the city, siya Sagay, no? And again, ha, Sagay has many names before, no? Unya raman siya na-change into Sagay during the American period, no? But before, it has many names. Actually, two raman, no? During the Spanish era. But why is it called Sagay? Because it comes from the semi-spherical shell called Sigay, okay? If you are fond of playing sungka, I don't know if it's called sungka in your dialect, no? Or in your language, wherein naisungka na yung mga shells nga usay gani ginahimo gyud na siya og kanang bracelet or necklace, no. Those are made from sigay shells, or even ang sigay shells ginahimo po na siya og lamps or mga chandeliers, no. So again, kanang sungka ang iyang mga ginagamit ng murag stones nga ibutang dira sa iyang mga hollow nga kuan, those are sigay shells. Okay, now Sagay was named after that because these sigay shells, these semi-spherical shells, they are all over the city of Sagay. Okay? Since coastal area man nun, syempre, ang main jud nga source of living sa una, sa Sagay, is fishing. And then, ang sentro nila is near the coastline. That's why, nga daghan kay mga sigay shells. Okay? Unlike sa mga uban nga mga municipalities or cities that is found within or in the middle of the Negros Island, no, landlocked siya. This guy is found near the coastline, near the sea. Okay. So on the other hand, Negros Occidental is a province in the Western Visayas region of the Philippines. It occupies the northwestern half of Negros Island. It is the seventh most populated province in the Philippines, and it is known for its chicken inasal and its boosting sugar industry, nicknamed as the Sugar Bowl of the Philippines. So why are we called Sugar Bowl of the Philippines and Negros Occidental? It is because we are the major producers of sugar. Okay, most of the areas that you see in Negros Occidental are covered with sugar cane plantations. Let us now proceed to the history of sagay, since this is the first one of our discussion. No? So, sagay was originally called Argueles when Lieutenant Francisco Rodriguez and Basilio Cordova founded it in 1860 in the mouth of the Bulanon River. Later, by the order of the Spanish governor, the town was transferred to Pueblo de Magallanes, now known as Old Sagay, in honor of Ferdinand Magellan. So again, before, next slide. Okay, so before, natawag siya class as sagay. Kaya ang sagay nga name class sa American period naman na siya na-apply, no? So before, ang pinakauna siya nga name is Argueles. Then later on, okay, the Spanish governor decided to change it to Pueblo de Magallanes. Okay, so, which was Old Sagay, no? Ang sentro sa una sa Sagay was Old Sagay, and then, na-transfer siya to Dalusan. Now, ang Pueblo de Magallanes means town, no? Then, Magallanes is the last name of Ferdinand Magellan. So, having a status of a pueblo, Sagay was entitled to have a Capitan del Pueblo. So, the Capitan del Pueblo class is the highest town official during that time. So, the first to be appointed by the Spanish governor was Eulalio Rodriguez, Gregorio Pareño, and Pedro Catalbas y Villanueva. So, which later succeeded him. Now, actually, it's also one of the advantages, no, and achievements of Sagay, because during the Philippine Revolution, no, during the Spanish era, because out of all the municipalities and cities who revolt, no, or struggle against sa mga Spaniards, Sagay was one of the successful municipalities during that time nga nagfought should against sa mga Espanyol and took over, no? Reoccupied Sagay, okay? Now, that hard-won, okay, First Philippine Republic was short-lived. So, ang freedom nga nasought sa mga Sagay nuns from the grasp of the Spaniards, no? Okay, we were colonized for 300 years. It was short-lived because the colonial power of Spain was later transferred to the United States of America in 1898, no, in the form of Treaty of Paris. So we thought that we were free from the Spaniards, no, but it was actually the real thing that happened is kanang na transfer ang colonial power sa mga Espanyol, gitransfer sa Amerikano, kay gipalit ra man ta for a cheaper price. Kay syempre di naman makontrol sa mga Espanyol ang mga Pilipino nga nag-fight against, no, sa ilaha. Okay. So, ang natabuan na class, we were sold to the Americans, gihimo ra Japon ta og colony, no? And then ang purpose nato sa mga Amerikano is we are actually near, it's a strategic plan, no, nila, kay we are actually near Japan and other Asian countries nga at that time, no, kontra pod sa mga Amerikano. And then knowing that, oh, we are a tropical country, we are near the Pacific Ocean, dool po kayo ta sa mga different natural resources. So it's actually very strategic to have a military base, no, in the Philippines, which is actually managed by the Americans. So since the colonial power was transferred to the Americans right after the 300 years ng colonization sa mga Espanyol, let us now proceed to the American period. But what happened during the American period class, it's not really that bad man dyan, no? Because there were a lot of things that happened in Sagay which helped the economy of Sagay to flourish, no? Nag-progress man ang kaano, progreso man ang municipality sa Sagay during this time. And then it was during this time that with the administration of the second president Benji Adolfo, the name of the town was officially changed to Sagay, which was taken from the semi-spherical shell called Sigay. So the American influence seeped into every aspect of Sagay's life, politically and culturally. Now, in here, no, in this era, you'll begin to understand how the economy of Sagay began to flourish, no, began to develop, no, because there were a lot of corporations, plantations that were built, no, public schools were established, amat-amat nag-transfer, no, ang sentro, no, sa municipality, no, or inland, okay? And then also there were a lot of opportunities for the Sagaynons to have jobs, to provide food for their families, no, and then also nag-open po na siya ang opportunities for Sagay to actually accept other people nga mag-migrate, no, other people coming from different places in the Philippines to migrate to Sagay to seek for greener pasture. So daghan kay development na tabo during the American period. So at this period of Sagay's history, land transportation began to supplant sea travel, okay, from sentro nila nga old Sagay. Amat-amat na nga, naanay mga roads nga gibuild, no? And then, napoy mga different train tracks, kay mas ginagamit na during the American period ang land transportation kaysa sea transportation. Although, gapadayon naman Japan og flourish ang seaside community. Okay, wala man siya po nawala Japan ang ilhang way of life. So, the first public schools conducted in English were also established. So, let us try to remember, no, that the public school system, that what we know today, is actually inspired or adapted from the Americans. It was the Americans who introduced the public school system. Not only that, our government was actually patterned also from the Americans. And it was the American missionaries and even soldiers who were sent to tutor more Filipino English teachers. So, during the time of the Spaniards, it was actually the religious leaders, no, sila man na ang maoy teachers, no, and they were Spaniards, no, sila man na yung mga teachers during the time sa Spanish era, no, Spanish colonization, and only the men were allowed to receive education, okay, especially katurang mga dato, okay, katong mga elites, no, katong mga Spanish mestizos. Ano po yung mga half Filipino, half Spanish, families nga, mga affluent families like personal lang si Rizal, no, nga medyo may kaya-kaya ang ilahang panginabuhi, no? So they were only allowed to go to school. Pero pag-abot sa mga Americans, no, they introduced the public school system, okay? Wherein everyone has an equal chance to go to school, learn how to speak in English, and it was not the Spaniards or the Americans who taught, no, these students or these children, but it was the Filipinos, okay? During this time, mga babae pa ang maoigi train nila, no, to teach Filipinos, no, Filipino children. Oh, so meanwhile, sometime in 1907, the Insular Lumber Company, so again, no, this is one of the pride of Sagay. No, it is because the Insular Lumber Company is the biggest hardwood lumber mill in the world. Okay? Meaning, kanang mga high-quality mahogany trees that are made into lumber. And sometimes we export that one outside of our country, na gina-enjoy pa sa mga other foreign countries, that is coming from Sagay. Okay? The mga durable mahogany trees that are used sa mga different houses, not just here in the Philippines, but even in other countries outside of the Philippines, gikan na sa Sagay. Okay? So, the Insular Lumber Company was established in now what we call Barangay Fabrica. Though measures to prevent the destruction of Sagay's rich forest were made, reforestation programs failed. Okay? It is because since, syempre, no, the biggest good, no, biggest hardwood lumber company or lumber mill in the world, si Insular Lumber Company, there were a lot of mahogany trees na gipang-cut and then gipanghimo into lumber. Later on, I will show you a video on how big noon sa kadako ni ang kani mga mahogany trees and how big the lumber products are, okay, made by Sagay, no, sa Insular Lumber Company. So, syempre, since daghan man in demand po siguro, no, kaya knowing the durability of these mahogany trees, muna, no, amat-amat na nakawala ang mga kahoy, and then when they decided to have reforestation, it did not actually succeed, maybe because di na sila kaapas, no? The number of trees or seedlings nga giplanted, no, to replace the old trees nga gikot, dili siya kaapas sa number of trees nga nangawala. So, meaning, wala ning succeed, no, ang ilahang reforestation programs. Okay? So, later, these forest areas, no, they convert this into sugarcane fields and corn fields. Okay? Since di naman siya matamnan, either the soil is not suitable enough to plant big mahogany trees, or the seedlings that they planted cannot grow big enough, just like sa una, or sa karaan nga mahogany trees, or either only few of the seedlings survive. So that is why nganing fail ang reforestation programs nila, and giconvert na lang nila ang kanang mga old forest areas nga wala na yung mga kahoy into sugarcane fields and some into corn fields. Okay? With the exhaustion of the forest resources of Sagay, so exhaustion nangahurot na, no, wala na yung nabilin. So, only few na lang nabilin ng mga mahogany trees. So, ang Insular Lumber Company in the Philippines was phased out in 1975 and then they transferred to Hinubaan. Okay? Kaya wala naman, nahurot naman ang mga trees sa Sagay. Mahogany trees, ha? Kasi may mga, napa may mga kahoy sa amuang lugar, ma'am. Katod yung mga super giants ng mga mahogany trees, no? Even larger than buildings. So, mo dito yung mga high-quality lumber, dun, no? Now, daghan makinig advantage sa Insular Lumber Company class. It provided a lot of jobs to people in Sagay. At the same time, they build a community out of it, no? Because of the Insular Lumber Company, na yung like community hospitals, marketplaces, and then some of the workers were able to send their kids to school, were able to put food on their table, and not only that also draw in a lot of people from Guimaras, Iloilo, Bohol, Cebu to come and migrate to Sagay to search for greener pastures. So, subong, no, other people would go to Manila or Cebu for better opportunities, pero sa una, they actually went to Sagay, no, for better job opportunities, knowing the success of the Insular Lumber Company. Okay? But sadly, again, no, double-edged sword po ni Sagay, not only that it brings, you know, the other side of it, it's a blessing because it brings progress, it brings economic success, no, to the community of Sagay. But the sad part about this is that the other side of it, because double-edged sword man siya, no, it can be both a blessing and a curse. The sad part about it is that since daghan man kay kahoy nga ginaputol, no, ginakot, it is also bad for the environment, no, due to deforestation. Now, before we will proceed to the Sugar Corporation, because that actually followed right after the Lumber Company, I will be showing you a video on the Insular Lumber Company. Oh, it's important na mas ma-visualize pa dyan ninyo, no, what the Insular Lumber Company looks like in the past. And then, please pay attention to the video because I will be asking some of your inputs, no, from or realizations from the video. Although this is a lengthy video class, no, it would take siguro mga 13 minutes, but please bear with me. Okay, and please watch, no, okay, it's a nice thing man to see the state of Sagay before, no, mga 1920s. Just saw, no, what are your realizations? It's most especially Insular Lumber Company, no, knowing that It has contributed so much to the history of Sagay. Okay? What were your insights from the video? What were your realizations? Most especially those who are actually born and raised in Sagay City. Okay? Siguro ang mga lolo and lola ninyo, no? Nakaabot pa na sila sa Insular Lumber Company. Any volunteers from the students here to share on silang mga insights, realizations from the video, most especially katong medyo strong internet connection, or were born and raised in Sagay City. Okay, kung gusto mag-answer, you can click the raise hand button or you can unmute your microphone. Okay, so daw wala man mag-volunteer. I'll just call someone. I'll ask Andre.
Yes, miss. Good evening.
Good evening.
Yes,
go ahead,
miss. Good
Andre.
Evening. Can I have the question again, miss? Can I have the question
Please
again,
the video
miss?
Sa Insular Lumber Company. What insights did you get from the video or any realizations, most especially knowing that mo na siyang itsura sang Sagay before, sa barangay fabrika before, okay?
After watching the video, miss, and compare sa bong, mas, I realize niya mas, ano gid ang environment, natural gid ang environment, damo sila mga trees, the past, which is natawagan ito biggest hardwork lumber in the or largest sawmill in the world because of rich tasang mga mahogani nga trees which is located in the fabrika. But until now, galas because gadamo man yung gadamo ang panimalay subong sang fabrika. So, mas ang main gidguro nga daw kabuhayan sa last sa past is sa mga tao is amo na siya ang pagkuha sa mga mahogani nga trees.
Okay, thank you so much,
realization,
Andre.
Miss.
Were you born and raised in Sagay?
Yes, miss. From Bulanon.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
so,
miss.
Thank you so
from
much.
Bulanon.
Okay, so that's why you are familiar with Barangay Fabrika, no? Because you are actually a Sagay, no? And that's a very good answer, no? So, makita niyo sa unang, damo ang mga trees, and then all natural lang, syempre, no? Mas damo ang mga trees and forest areas, no, compare sa subong nga medyo kuan naman, no, urbanized na, daghan na og mga balay, no, panimalay, pero at least, no, nakita nato nga, ah, okay, sa una di ay, no, dagko di kay mga mahogany trees before, super giants actually, kay kung makita ninyo sa video, although hindi man siguro klaro sa iban, don't worry, I'll just send you a link of the video para maklaro pagid ninyo, no. So, who else would like to add? Sige, isa lang so that we can continue. How about from the ladies? I'll call, how about Miss Cheryl? Biscocho? Miss Cheryl?
Good evening, miss.
Evening.
Good evening, miss.
Some of your insights from the video that I just showed you a while ago.
Amin sa mga kunya tot sa subong nga ano basang ligad nga mga ano insa ay sa mga ano nga sa plaza asan na anan ko lang na abtan ko lang bala sa plaza miss nga ano ligad daw na siya da mga mauga nito subong dogi pa ko na nila ano kay gipang tubuan na nila mga building. Then naman nga daw, grabe na gid ang mga improvements sa bung sa aton nga Sagay.
Thank you so much, Miss Cheryl. Okay, so guys, yes, Renz? Go ahead. Go ahead, Renz. Mumbai, you can unmute your microphone and share with us your insights.
Ang insight kami sa ano sa pabrika sa una kalagko pa sa mga puno tapos damo pa ang tao ang kinanglan magutod sa puno para mautod nila tapos ang taytay sa una miss ng kahoy pa na, sa subong ano na still na that's my ano miss.
Okay, thank you so much. It's actually good to hear no? Because I've been to Sagay only a few times lang. Actually, galabay lang ko sa Sagay. One time lang ko naka-visit gid sa lugar. Wala ko ka-explore. And then, at least, no, hearing from you, muna siya ang changes, especially from wood to steel. And then, also, based sa inyohang mga observations sa inyohang city, sa how it progress over time. Okay, so thank you so much, Renz. Desiree, can you share with us your insights?
After watching the videos, I realized that may mga methods sila ginagamit like backing and skidding and many more. But now may mga kahoy man Japan ginagamit pero hamba nila mas mahal na ang mga kahoy. Kay more on cement na ang nakita ko sa Sagay Mills.
And then subong mas I think the safer way nga especially during calamities like fire, the safer way lang nga hindi gidali mahurot, no? I don't know if you can understand hurot, pero, I mean, mahurot ang tanan nga mga balay is if it's made from concrete. Kaya just one example, no? From our own school itself, di ba? I think, you've already heard naman what happened to our school last semester, no? That's why I wasn't able to have my discussion a few days, no? Atong first meetings pala nato last sem. The main building, its flooring, no, is made from wood. That's why dali lang na siya nag-scatter or nag-transfer ang flames, no, pa ibabaw. Kay old na siya ang building itself, no. 90 years na nag-stand ang building. So, muna siya nga, it's a disadvantage. Also, if makita nyo, most of the buildings now are made from concrete and steel because it's far more durable na pod, no? I'm not saying nga kanang the mahogany trees are not durable. They are durable. In fact, some of the mahogany trees, no, the lumber made from the mahogany trees in Sagay na gina-export sa Japan, naraman Japan up until today, no? Pero few na lang. Okay, just like what you've mentioned, no? Subong. Okay, Zarina, go ahead.
Na-realize ko miss na medyo gali advanced na gali mga technology ang una pa lang kay training na nga gina-deliver sa mga ano arang mga kahoy tapos may arap sila machine na ginagamit para mahipit ang pagutod sa mga kahoy.
Thank you so much, Serena. So, thank you so much for your answers, everyone, no? And I'm very glad that all of you are very participative. And actually, mas ma-appreciate po nato ang lesson if we see some of the videos na natabo gid sa Sagay before. And knowing nga, 1920s pa lang to ang video, nag-start 1907 ang Insular Lumber Company. Pero I agree with Zarina, no, very high-tech na sila kay dali ra ang pag-process from mahogany to lumber. Then makita ninyo, no, ang finished product ng lumber kay very tall po siya, no. Dagko po kayo siya kay... Given nga, it also came from super giant trees, no, super giant mahogany trees sa Sagay nga forest. So sadly, hindi naman like what you've all mentioned just a while ago, hindi naman ito makita ang same yun nga kadagko gin nga trees unlike before. Pero at least, no, some part of history na preserve man to siya ang kato in a form of videos or pictures sa state or itsura ni Sagay before siya nahimo og syudad and before nawala ang Insular Lumber Company. Pero exist naman Japan siya today, no, na-transfer lang siya sa hinubaan. Now, let us proceed to our next discussion. So actually, class, 5 eras man lang ang ato ang i-discuss, no, under the history of Sagay. We are still in the American period, pero we're almost done. After this, we have the World War II, and then post-war era. And then, right after the conversion of Sagay as a city, please take note of the names like Alfredo G. Marañón Jr. because these he is one of the people who actually made a huge contribution, not just to Nonescos or State University of Northern Negros, but also to the city of Sagay. So no wonder nga, he is really beloved dun sa mga Sagaynons because of his contribution sa atuang, sa inyo nga siya, dad. Although I'm not a Sagay nun, no, but I'm really proud and happy sa progress ni Sagay given nga it has actually survived World War II, no. Later on we will discuss World War II. Very short lang na siya, it will not take long, pero mas ma-appreciate na to ang all of the sacrifices the Sagay nuns made in order for you, the future generations, to enjoy Sagay City today. So right after the Insular Lumber Company class, arina ni ang Lopez Sugar Corporation in the 1920s. Okay? So, this is another big corporation that has helped the development of the economy of Sagay. Okay? Kay, syempre, napulihan sa mga trees, ang nag-replace sa mga trees class nga nangaputol na is ang sugarcane plantations, coconut, corn, and also cornfields. That is why, during this years, sugar, copra, which is made from coconut meat, lumber and fishing became the important source of income for the inhabitants. Before the World War II, I would also like to mention that because of the economic growth of Sagay, it brought about influx of migrants. Mingi taog influx gani, no? Damo ang nag-abot. Okay? Nga migrants from Iloilo, Guimaras, Cebu, and Bohol. Which is why, if you have noticed, Sagay is a melting pot of ethnically different but equally hardworking Cebuanos and Ilonggos. You can see that some of the Sagaynons has a mix of both Cebuano and Ilonggong culture. Okay, so with these developments, the business industry, no, in Sagay has flourished. That's why dira na nagawas, no, ang mga different industrialists and businessmen like the Lopezes, the Gisons, the Gamboas, the Vasquez, and even the sugar boom in Sagay City brought old families, no, into the industry like the Pues, the Nichols, the Catalbases, the Tupases. Ang Pues became one of the kuan po, no, kanang forefront sa Negros politics together with the Marañons, no. We also have the De La Paz, the Ebrados, and the Libuons. These were the old families, prominent families, nga nag-branch out, no, during the American period because they dealt with different businesses, different industries. So, although, no, we were actually colonized by the Americans, but it actually brought a bit of an advantage to the municipality of Sagay. So, I'm calling it municipality of Sagay because during the time, it was still a municipality. It was not. It was only during after, no, the World War II nga nahimo na og syudad ang Sagay, specifically 1996, no. So let's now proceed to World War II. During the Japanese occupation, let us try to remember, ha, because this will come out of the exam. There are two civil governments that existed in Sagay. So during the World War II class, no, gi-occupy ta sa mga Japanese, I will not call it colonization, but I mean murag gi-invade ta, no, sa mga Hapon. So with this, there were actually people from Sagay who were against the Japanese, okay? That's why there are two civil governments in Sagay, in the municipality of Sagay. So the first one is under the Japanese National Government of Jose Laurel Sr., which was Vicente Catalbas, who was the appointed mayor. While the second civil government is the resistance government of Free Sagay. Mingon kitag resistance government class, this is against the Japanese. Okay? This was headed by Alfredo Montelebano Sr. as the governor, and he appointed Tomas Londres as the mayor. Since they are against the Japanese, no, kay resistance government man siya class, they had to seek shelter, no, and also seek a separate seat of government. So ilang seat of government kay naa sa mountain areas of Sitio Balibag, Lopez Haina. Okay, so ang sa Japanese national government naa sa sentro dito sa Sagay. Now, because they are part of the Japanese occupation, they were allowed man to have the government in Sagay, while Katungagan sa Japanese, they had to seek refuge sa mountain area so that they will not be captured by the Japanese. Okay? So, their term, however, abruptly ended. Okay? So, ang Japanese occupation abruptly ended, not just in Sagay but also in Negros Occidental, when the Filipinos and American forces, no, they combined, no, their efforts to liberate, no, and free the province from the Japanese at the early part of 1945. Okay? So, during the time class, if you remember, Sergio Osmeña Sr., ha, he was the vice president to Manuel L. Quezon, who was the president of that time, no? So, he died during the war. That's why Sergio Osmeña Sr. took over as the president. Kaya namatay man si Manuel L. Quezon during the war. So, Teodoro Lopez Sr. was appointed as mayor of Sagay. So, during his term, si Teodoro Lopez Sr. concentrated in rebuilding the administrative machinery of the local government. Okay. Now, muna siya, no, nga, na-free na ang Sagay, ang province of Negros Occidental in 1945 with the combined forces of the Filipino and Americans. And then, muna na na-appoint ang first nga mayor sa Sagay after the war, who was Teodoro Lopez Sr. Let us go previously to that, pero no, mo concept ah, balik sa juta sa during the Japanese period, no. So before ana siya class, there were a lot of devastating events that happened in Sagay City before we were freed, no, with the help of the Filipino and Americans. Okay, so there were several factories that were destroyed and the economy was also in shambles. There were several schools and establishments that were used by the Japanese as an incarceration area, as an area where they seek shelter, no? Or ilang gihimo nga kanang prisuhan, no, sa mga captured Filipinos and American soldiers. Okay? So, an example of that is the Eusebio Lopez Memorial School in Barangay Paraiso, which served as an incarceration area for captured Filipino soldiers and American pilots and soldiers. If we talk about incarceration area, it means nga ginahimo siya as prisuhan or jail, ginahimo po na siya as torture area kung diin nila katong mga captured Filipino and American soldiers, ito nila gina-torture for intel, for information. So, not only that, no, the school itself, Eusebio Lopez Memorial School, it also served as a headquarters for the 4th Flight Division of the Japanese Imperial Air Force, okay, which ang ilang airfield was located in Pulabong Las area in Barangay Malubon. During the last years of the war, the 4th Flight Division of the Japanese Imperial Air Force organized a kamikaze. No, ang kamikaze class is a form of suicide, no? So, kada suicide units, no, every time nga they encounter, let's say, American pilots, or for example, kanang kinahanglan nila i-crash ang ilang aircraft sa usa ka building para mapildi ilang kontra, no, so they would conduct kamikaze, no. Ang kamikaze class is suicide, no. So para nila, if suicide made by pilots, no, Japanese Imperial Air Force. So for them, for the Japanese, it is considered honorable if they died during the war, if they died fighting for their country. Okay, that is their beliefs. That's why they have also like seppuku, no. There's another term for seppuku. But sometimes it's called seppuku, no. Kanang they would take a blade and then ilaha nang i mag-gisiun. I don't know if you can understand the word gisi, no. Ilahan nang i-stab ang ilang stomach, and then ilahan nang i-cut open ilang stomach, and then muna, no, i-imbowel nila lang self. Yung kag-imbowel gani, kanang ang ilahang mga innards, silang intestines, kay muna, mugawas, no, kaya lamang i-cut across ang ilang stomach, and then they would do it themselves. Sila mismo ang muhimu ana. That's why, if they will conduct seppuku, someone has to be there to behead them so that it will end their agony. Okay, they would do this if ever nga they would do something nga that is considered not honorable, or if they made a promise and wala sila ning commit sa kana nga promise. Okay, so yung ana jud ka true to their word ang mga Japanese, okay? So not only ang school kana discuss naman mga Japanese. So not only ang mga schools class ang gihimo siya as incarceration area. Paragay 3 War Fabrica also serve as a transport point of the processed lumber destined to Japan from Insular Lumber Company and also a docking area of the Japanese supply ship during the war-torn years. Okay? So muna no, that's why some of the houses no in Japan are actually made from the lumber in Sagay. Okay, kaya they used to transport processed lumber to their own country. And dira pud gihimo pud siya og kanang dock class no nga kung mag-transport sila og mga supplies nila or food no or weapons coming from Japan. Now, it is also said that Inglanggam Bridge at Barangay Tadlong, I don't know if it's considered haunted today, no? But it served as a dumping site of executed local soldiers, guerrillas, and civilians. This is also known as the site where confiscated money. So it is said nga, while the Japanese, no, were fleeing from the Americans and from the Filipinos who would like to take back, no, Sagay, they had to throw away their money, no, in the Inglanggam Bridge. So this money, kani mga silver peso coins, were encased in concrete blocks. So ginsemento siya, then gidump nila sa Inglanggam Bridge. So not only mga dead bodies ang gipanglabay dito, but also money, okay, treasures. Let us now proceed to Balibag Hill, Lopez Haina. It's important that you remember that, di ba, Balibag Hill, Lopez Haina was the place where the seat of the resistance government of Free Sagay under Mayor Tomas Londres was established. So if you can still remember, there are two civil governments, di ba, sa Sagay during World War II, during the Japanese occupation. You have the Japanese National Government, which is ang mayor sa Sagay at the time, is si Vicente Catalbas, while the second civil government is the resistance government of Free Sagay under Tomas Londres as the mayor. So, syempre, they had to seek refuge sa Balibag Hill because they were against the Japanese, and if they were caught, no, conspiring against the Japanese, they would be captured and killed. Which eventually happened, no, kay kaning Balibag Hill was also known as a tabuan or marketplace during the war. And in 1944, probably like a spy or someone who betrayed, no, Mayor Tomas Londres, a group of Japanese soldiers knew about the resistance government in Balibag Hill. And they went there and killed about 27 home guards or toltog guerrillas. So after the mass killing, wala pa jud, no, nasatisfied ang mga Hapon. They set the whole area on fire and it burned a lot of shanty houses. May mga shanty houses, ganit klas ka ng mga barong-barong made from nipa, mga nipa huts ba? And then also, katong mga 27 soldiers ng gipatay, na-appeal po sila kasunog. Okay? So, if ang Balibag Hill, Lopez Haina was the place of the resistance government of Free Sagay, ang puppet government or the Japanese puppet government under Vicente Lacson Catalbas was established at the Big House Central Lopez Paraiso. Don't worry, kay there are some details here nga wala sa slide, pero I'll just give you a full detail of the history of Sagay. Okay, so nasa Barangay Paraiso. So gihimo dirag mga Japanese barracks and checkpoint nag-establish so that walay mga Filipino under the resistance government nga muagto sa Big House Central Lopez to kill, okay, Vicente Lacson Catalbas and the other Japanese soldiers that are there, okay? So not only that, no, a training site of USAFFE or United States Army Forces in the Far East under the supervision of Lieutenant Dominador Garland was also established at Tangnonon Barangay Fabrica at the ancestral home of Lopez Caballo. Well, let us now proceed to the post-war period. So after the World War II. So after the Second World War, Jose BP Sr. and Amalio Cuevas Sr., Mayor and Vice Mayor, respectively, was elected respectively, no, by the Sagaynons. However, ang mayorship ni Jose BP Sr. was cut short because he was appointed as one of the members of the Provincial Board of Negros Occidental. Therefore, si Vice Mayor Amalio Cuevas Sr. took over the municipal leadership. Okay, so he became mayor. Okay, and through his initiative, the seat of government was transferred to its present site in Dalusan. So, before, it was Old Sagay, who was the center, jud, no, sa municipality. Pero gi-change siya sa Dalusan. Okay? Now, the transfer actually signaled the diminishing importance of sea travel because this was already established during the American period nga slowly nag-transfer ang ato ang modes of transportation from sea travel to land travel. Pero gi further cement pa jud siya ni Mayor Amalio Cuevas Sr. So he moved, no, the seat of government to Dalusan. Okay? So that would mean nga ang importance of sea travel slowly diminish and ning take over na ang land transportation as a conveyor of progress and development. So Old Sagay, which was the previous seat of the government, is an old coastal center of the population while si Dalusan is a late highway occurrence. So how was this made possible? So the transfer was made possible through the land donations for the town site by Doña Rosario Cooper and the heirs of the late Clayton Nichols. So, di ba familiar ang name ng Nichols, no? Because these were one of the prominent families, old families, no? That actually came out after the Sugar Corporation, no? Nga na-established during the American period. So, what happened to Jose BP Sr.? Because short-lived raman ang iyahang pagka-mayor sa Sagay right after the Second World War. So, he remained the provincial board member until his election, rather, as congressman for the 1st District of Negros Occidental in 1953. Now, it was not only Jose BP Sr., now congressman, now later turned to congressman from 1953 to 1957. So, he was also joined by Alfredo A. Marañón Sr., who became board member from 1956 to 1959. So remember these names, ha, because their children, right after them, ning follow sa ilang footsteps in Negros politics. Okay? So since si Alfredo A. Marañón Sr., dili ni siya ang father of Nanescos, ha, kay ang junior ang father of Nanescos na to, no? Alfredo G. Marañón Jr. So, kani si Alfredo A. Marañón Sr., og si Jose BP Sr. were at the forefront of Negros politics, meaning mas damo ang support, no, provincial and national support nga ma-extend sa Sagay. That is why progressive ang Sagay up until today because two Sagaynons were part of the provincial politics, no. So there were more roads and school buildings that were constructed. Thousands of hectares of log-off area of the Insular Lumber Company were replaced with coconut trees and sugar cane. So, not only that, no, Sherman Hill near Barangay Bato was discovered to contain rich deposits of highest silica. And there were also growing markets for sea products. Kay even though, no, nag-slowly nagbalhin man si Sagay sa land, no? Land ang ilang sentro na wala na sa coastal area, ga-flourish naman Japon ang coastal community. That's why nag-grow po ang ilang mga sea products and naay unprecedented boom in the fishing industry. So right after that, no, kay nag-continue nag-flourish ang Sagay even after the Second World War, ning saka, no, ning rise ang population ni Sagay up to 60,000. And not only that, even the revenue of the municipality increased. So after Mayor Amalio Cuevas Sr., who followed him was Tereso Canoy, Bruno Cuevas Sr., and Quintin Catalbas. So, diba, no, si Jose P. Sr., who became congressman sa Negros Occidental, and together with Alfredo Marañon Sr. also, na board member, ang ilang mga anak ning follow silang footsteps. Just like Jose H. Puy Jr., he became mayor of Sagay in 1963. So the income continued to rise, more schools were built, and more roads linking the barangays to the town capital were constructed. So not only that, no, because of Jose H. Puy Jr., ang electrical system was updated, firefighting equipment and political units were modernized, and it was during this time that Alfredo Marañon Sr., ang father ha, began entertaining the idea of putting up another sugar mill in Sagay, which farmers can partly own. So he campaigned actually for support, no? But sadly, wala may ning support, even ang friends ni Alfredo Marañon Sr., wala ning support siyang idea to put up a sugar mill which farmers can own. Okay? So when he died, okay, anyway, yung efforts wala man na put to waste, no, kay even if wala siya nakakita, kay after his death pa man nahimog realization ang iyahang dream, his dreams were actually respected and made possible, no, by the help of former President Ferdinand E. Marcos Sr. and then Philippine National Bank President Roberto S. Benedicto. So with the new sugar mill at Barangay Bato class, no, new areas were opened and it actually benefited hundreds of small farmers. So kasing wala siya nakaabot ato, no, kay he died before his dreams were made realized, no, but at least, no, even though his friends did not believe in him, but at least, no, there was a former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. and also the PNB Bank President, no, who shared his vision and made that possible. Well, let us now proceed to his son, Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. He was then mayor, congressman, and then governor of Negros Occidental, Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. So he assumed the political leadership of Sagay in 1972. Under his administration, there were a lot of establishments that were actually established, and then daghan po kayo og mga gipang-acquire nga new sponsorship from other countries. So under his administration, Sagay acquired a new town hall, a municipal gymnasium, a livestock auction market, public markets for a number of barangays, and municipal wharves in barangays Vito and Old Sagay. Not only that, he also caused the organization of Sagay Water District in 1978. So he effected the purchase of a municipal subdivision for municipal employees in 1979. So take note how long before pa, no, if you can still remember the history of Nunescos or State University of Northern Negros, it was through the efforts of Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. that helped develop Nunescos, no, to what it is today. Okay? Mabalaan man inyo class nga, although wala pa to ka klase dyan, no, kaya ka ng video recording naman to. Mabalaan inyo class nga, he established an Old Sagay Barangay High School, and up until nahimo siya as Iloilo State College of Fisheries, Sagay Branch, and then through his efforts put as well, nga nag-sponsor siya og law, converting ISCOF, Sagay Branch, into Nunescos, makita ninyo nga, yung efforts, wala lang nag-stop sa school lang nato, no, but nag-extend po siya sa whole Sagay City. Okay? So, damo kayo siya mga buildings na ipatukod, mga developments. So, these achievements by themselves have helped Sagay, no, became a first-class C municipality. And if you talk about being a first-class C municipality, during the time, it is the highest in the entire Negros. Not only that, no, ang magnum opus, no, or the greatest achievement ni Mayor Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. is his successful negotiation of the sponsorship contract with the German district of Osterholz. Now, this achievement actually provided books, no, and support to Nunescos during that time. So again, no, not only nga nag-contribute siya mga daghan kay infrastructures, or since he was also named as the father of Nunescos, kay syempre na develop po niya ang Nunescos pod. si Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. also sponsored, no, a law converting Sagay into a city. So it had been a long time aspiration to get Sagay a city status. So the leadership of Mayor Joseph G. Marañon and Vice Mayor Fortunato S. Javilosa inspired the authorship of Congressman Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. of House Bill Number 6543, an act converting the municipality of Sagay into a component city of Negros Occidental during the 10th Congress. Passing through the legislation process, a public hearing was held in Sagay City on February 2, 1996. So manog 28 years na si Sagay as a city, charter day na ninyo. So Senator Raul Rocco sponsored the Senate Bill number 1191, the Senate version of the cityhood. On June 11, 1996, then President Fidel V. Ramos signed into law RA 8192, now the Charter of Sagay City. So June 11, 1996, this coming June 11, 2024, that will be your 28th year, no, as a city. So imagine, no? And then after 2 years, 1998, nahimo pug UNESCO's, no, ang ISCOF or Iloilo State College of Fisheries Sagay Branch. And that is all through the efforts of Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. So he is basically not just the father of the UNESCO's, but he was one of those important people who contributed to the development of Sagay. So on June 10, 1996, the residents voted and ratified RA 8192 and made Sagay officially Sagay City. And that ends my discussion for tonight. Please kindly remember all that we have discussed for this evening, because not only that it will come out of the exam, but it will also be our basis for the activity that I will be posting tonight. Okay? Our activity is very simple. You are just going to answer one question, and it is based on the development of Sagay City over the years. And you will be submitting that one on Wednesday. Oh, so you can enjoy your weekend, and then most probably Monday, Tuesday ninyo na siya ansiran. Pwede magani tonight, no? Basta dili lang mo mula pa sa Wednesday, because once nga mula pa siya sa deadline, I will no longer accept late submissions, okay? So is that clear, everyone? If that is clear with all of you, you can click the raise hand. Oh no, the raise hand button. Before we will end, I would just like to take the attendance first. So if you are present, also kindly kanang paki hands down kay mo check na ko sa inyong attendance. If you are present, you can click the raise hand button once I call your name, or you can unmute your microphone and say present. Okay, let us start with Arellano. Karen Balayo. Rushana. Biscocho Cheryl. Joanne Kakulba. Yorella Kahanap. Benmar Kanya Fuego. Janville Cañete. Jel Grace. Chastin Jane. Joshua,